guys, it's me again. It's your friend, Jane, and I wanted to do something slightly different today because, I don't know, you know, sometimes you don't want to fucking come up with a topic to talk about and, you know, over your speed paint so you could, I don't know, inspire people. You know, sometimes you just want to sit and talk over your painting. And I'm going to do that because, I don't know, I'm not a machine. I'm not a wise person. I can't just turn it out all the time. So, also, I really like movies. I love movies. And one of my favorite things about movies is when there's, like, a behind the scenes. Is it? Not really behind the scenes. Like, you know when they have those DVDs or whatever? Showing my age, but, you know, when they used to have DVDs and it would have the normal movie and then it have the whole movie, like the whole like hour and whatever, but with including commentary. And I remember, like, I didn't know what that word was as a kid. I'm like, what the hell is commentary? So I'm thinking it's the whole movie, but it's like the extra shit or whatever. So I click it and it was just them. It was the whole movie and then it's just these people talking. I'm like, what the fuck? But hearing it, it's like, oh, that's interesting. Like, it's literally them just saying everything they felt while they were making it. And I'm digressing, but basically this is what this video is about. So yeah, here's me trying to kind of emulate that. It's not gonna be as exciting because it's not a movie you're watching, it's just me talking over a painting. But yeah, anyway, first painting. So this was a study I did of Keanu. And they're both studies of Keanu, because, come on. But really, honestly, I really enjoy, like, how Keanu, especially in his youth, he has this, like, natural concealer look that I'm so fucking obsessed with. And I've been dying to, like, capture that. So I tried to kind of do it with these two paintings, but mostly with this painting, because I feel like you can really see, like, the white cast, I guess, come out. And yeah, I really liked it. I also wanted for this painting, I really wanted a more creamy look, because one of my friends, who is an amazing artist, they're named Star, and they did these studies of Ted, and also of, I think it was Alex Winter, yeah, in a movie, and the brush they used, I guess it was like a round brush, but it was like, it had this creamy look to it, and it looked really nice, and it looked digital, but like, it didn't look, you know, usually digital paintings can be like kind of stale. It didn't look stale at all. It was like really lively and creamy, and I'm like, oh man, I want to do that. So it's good to have art friends. They always inspire you. But yeah, with this painting, I kind of attempted that really wet on wet look. It was also kind of nerve-wracking though, because I was live streaming, so I think it was my first live stream where I did like a paint study, and my paint studies, like every painting, there's an awkward stage. Like right now you can see it, like I kind of don't know where I'm at, like I'm figuring it out. But so it was pretty hard because I'm like, oh, people are seeing the awkward stage, like especially when it comes to the stubble. Oh god, it was so hard. Stubble was something that I actually had to learn to love, because it was really, it's so complicated at first, but whenever it comes to stubble, I constantly have to think about, like, what my professor told me in college, where he's just like, you know, when it comes to stubble, don't paint every individual one, just kind of paint bigger blocks, and it looks way better. And I think he's right. I think he's right about that. There's a lot of pauses on this too. It kind of pisses me off, which is why I don't like, I prefer to have my microphone on when I'm streaming. Oh, Bill and Ted! Sorry, it's exciting seeing that. Oh, and the nose surgery. There's a lot of stuff that happened here. See, when I'm drawing like normally, and I do like, I take the lasso tool and I like pick it out, it's, and move things, it's normal, it's fine, but when you're at this stage of the painting, like you could kind of see it coming together, it almost has an uncanny look to it. So when I take like the lasso tool, like when I did that, I kind of felt wrong doing it. It was kind of weird. I feel kind of gross almost, or guilty. It's not real surgery, but it feels like it. But yeah, this it's pretty interesting how different this painting looks from the next one that I do. I feel like it's a lot more stylized, which I don't mind, because I prefer my stuff to be stylized. I just wish his mouth didn't look so strange. Ugh, get my headphones off. But yeah, I feel like his mouth came out kind of weird, but I don't know, for some reason that's how I see it. See, it's pausing again. It's so annoying, because I'm typing while I'm painting, so, but it's so annoying to edit, so I'm just leaving them in because I'm lazy. Like, I don't want to fucking cut all those parts. It's boring. But I really love seeing how this painting comes together, though. Like, now I'm like, ooh, this is where it gets fun. Oh, my stream died, so I had to move to Picardo. But yeah, this is where it gets really fun, because you see it all come together and it's like everything starts to click. If there's anything I learned this year about painting, it's that you just have to literally keep going, because you'll eventually figure it out. And I think I, when I did my, which I wish I did a speed paint of, it was one day I had a stomach ache, or I had indigestion because I'm old, and I'm like, oh, I don't want to sleep, I don't want to, but I really want to draw. So I just had my tablet out and I did a study of Keanu, and I tried to paint it, because before that my studies were okay. I feel like they always looked like I didn't know what to do, so I just left it like that, and I'm like, I'm tired of them looking like that. So I decided to paint and just keep going until my stomach stopped feeling icky, and it came out great. And I'm like, what? And the thing was, I ended up just not caring about how it looked. So by not caring, it helped me get past the ugly stage that I never get past, you know. Usually when I used to paint, I would just paint it as much as I could, and then when it looked ugly, I just like got rid of those layers and just like posted it. But yeah, so with this, seeing like the way Keanu looks now in this painting, I would never get this far in the painting ever. So it's pretty exciting seeing like how I feel like I kind of leveled up a little bit. But yeah, I think my favorite part about this is definitely spinning it. You probably saw it, like I spin the canvas around, because I don't know, I like to know that it looks good at all angles, you know, not just one angle. Some people flip their canvas left and right. I do that too, but I really like to just spin it around, because I don't know, I think that helps me a lot. His forehead is also massive in this one. I hope I edited it. But if I didn't, whatever, you know, it is what it is. Also, highlights are really fucking, that's something I never learned. I hate highlights. I hate putting them in, because they always look like they're graying, like their hair is graying out. So I usually avoid highlights, but I kind of tried to like speckle them in there or sprinkle them in there. And clothes is another thing I never learned, because I hate painting clothes. It's just nothing interesting about it for me. It's dead fabric, you know. Not that fabric is ever alive, but I don't know, there's just nothing interesting to me about it. I try to make it interesting by adding like random colors and shapes, but it's nothing like the face, man. Face just has all these different kinds of I don't know if you hear Neil, but hey, mother. Anyway, it has all different kinds of like reds and blues and yellows and purples. Maybe not purple, I don't know. But yeah, like especially in his face, like for me, I like to just really exaggerate the blushes and stuff. I know his face doesn't have that much blush, but it's so fun to add it. Why not add it? So yeah, with faces, I love it. I love working on faces. You can also see me struggling with a background here. I don't know, I really want, I wanted the black because his face stands out, but I hated that the shape of his hair went away. Like, I really wanted that shape. So, but I also like the orange. I liked how the orange came out. It's really cool. I think it really complements the blue highlights of his concealer. So I'm like, you know, why not, you know, make two? ¿Por qué no dos? You know, like, why not? So I made variants. So there's one with the black background and one with the orange background. And I think that works. And then going to print class helped me realize that, you know, doesn't, if you like another version, you could always just have two versions or five. Who cares? It's your fucking art, you know? But yeah, it's pretty much wrapping up in this part. It's just me checking my values. Looking at this sped up, I look like a psychopath. Like, just spinning my canvas and clicking the value thing. But I don't know, that's the best way I can check, you know? I think I'm fixing his gigantic forehead here. Am I? I don't know. It's also crazy looking at your art again. Because for me, I didn't like it. Like, when I finished it, I liked it. And the next day, I'm like, oh, I don't really like it. I feel like his chin's too big. He kind of has that, like, anime, very exaggerated chin. I guess it's like a yaoi chin, but yeah, I don't like it. It's weird. So I think I did fix it later. You'll see it. But yeah, here I was kind of tired too. Because, you know, I was fucking trying to stream all day. And then, you know, your stream dies and it's really frustrating. I don't know what's been going on with my streaming stuff, but I got an Ethernet cord, so I hope that works. But there he is dancing. Okay, so this is the next day. Yeah. I shaved his chin. I gave him more surgery. And I think that looks a little bit better. I still think his lips... I think his lips look a little off. But, you know, if you squint, it looks like him. So I guess that's good enough. I did attempt to fix his mouth, but it looked weird. I think I cut it from here. It looked really weird. It looked scary. So I don't want to scare you guys. It's not October yet. So, yeah. I just skipped to the part where I just added some finishing touches. And, yeah. Overall, I give this painting a good B+. I like it. I feel like the likeness could have been better. But the top half, I think his likeness rocks. Bottom half, eh. But, you know, I like the speckles of the highlights, too. That's pretty fun. But yeah, this painting is finished, so I don't know what else to say. Except that I'm pretty proud of myself here, so yeah. On to the second painting. I hope you guys like this one, because this second painting is actually my favorite one. I kind of went whole hog on it, so yeah. Enjoy the second one. Okay. Welcome to the second painting. The second, now see, this painting is pretty fun. I think it's pretty groovy, it's pretty righteous, pretty epic, pretty radical. I just love it. I think it was probably one of my favorites that I've done so far. I think it's because I just kind of like, I whole hogged it. I just went crazy. And I didn't care too much about performance because I didn't stream this one. I think that's also why I think it looks better. I didn't realize how fast I drew this part. I mean, you know, the when it comes to painting, like, the drawing part, it doesn't have to be accurate. He kind of has bedroom eyes now. But yeah, the drawing part, it doesn't have to be as accurate. So it's just about getting the foundations and all that. Yeah, this is one of my favorites also, because I love that picture. This picture of Keanu is so elegant. I don't know who took it, but oh my god, like, they deserve the raise, because it's just so nice. Not even because he's such a cutie, but also because, like, the way his hair just perfectly like frames his face, the way his skin is glowing like it's an old Hollywood film, you know, that glow effect, it's awesome, it's radiant, and I'm just like, I have to do this one, I have to, it's perfect. Because originally I just wanted to study the one with him just looking, but yeah, I just really enjoy this whole painting. It's just fun. I also wanted to have a more speckly look. See, this one I didn't want it to look as digital. I wanted it to have traditional kind of like dryness to it or strokes. And so I picked a painting by, I don't know the artist's name, but I will put it. You'll see it. By this artist on Instagram. I really love his application. I usually like to make big shapes, and I don't usually, you're supposed to start off like that, like I am here, big shapes, but I don't usually do that, those little like, ooh, those little specks of paint where you're like slowly but surely getting to it because I'm impatient. But I wanted to try it for this painting. So yeah, this is that ugly stage I'm talking about. You couldn't really see it in the first one, but here, oh man, it's fun. Another interesting fact about this, I don't even know if I said a first interesting fact, but an interesting fact about this painting is that I did all this with Efflux on. So Efflux is this program that makes your fucking screen like really orange, because again, I am old, I have old man eyes, I hate blue screens, you know, it's not good for your eye health either. But basically, it reddens or oranges up your screen so that you don't strain as much. And sometimes I like to paint with it because, I don't know, because when I first did that painting, when I had my tummy ache, I had Efflux on because I had indigestion. The last thing I wanted was a bright light in my face. So I'm like, whatever, I'm just going to paint it with Efflux on and see how it looks. And I did it, and it's interesting seeing it because you can see that I'm not leaning towards warm tones as much as I usually am. Like, yeah, the tones are warmish, but not as warm as the first painting. So that's why I'm excited for you guys to see the results of this one, because it's basically me painting with a filter on. It's pretty cool seeing it now, because I didn't really see the whole thing. But yeah, this double was giving me like fucking hell. Again, stubble is really, like, I like it now, but here, I was really struggling with it. Actually, this whole thing kind of was pretty hard now that I look back at it. I thought the first one was a lot harder, but this one was, yeah, and it's, I guess because there's so much light in his face, you know? There's not enough harsh shadows, like, there's just one harsh shadow, which is on his neck. But, you know. Oh my god. But, yeah. I also didn't like how bright his teeth were. So I'm like, I'm gonna dull it up. I hate painting like pure white teeth and eyes. It's disgusting to me. So I'm like, yeah, you know what? Because his teeth look and eyes look kind of bright. But I just didn't want to add it. I didn't think it would fit like the way I do it. But yeah, it's pretty fun just seeing like how everything slowly, because right now it's let's be real, folks, it's pretty ugly. But I am so looking forward to see like when you can see the gears in my brain turn and be like, oh, this is what I gotta do, or this is what's gonna make it look good. And you can almost see that happening. Yeah, his eyes were pretty hard too though. Because his left or right eye, whichever one it is, it looks so good. Like, it's like, it's just wandering. And I still don't know if I captured that as well. But it was something I really thought was very important. I also did this pretty late too. I think it's 2 a.m. So there's a certain time when you're a little tired and your brain can't really do its job that well when it comes to art because you're so tired. And I think it was kind of hitting me a little bit, but I managed. And I could tell because I was tired, because I thought the shadow of his hair was another hair strand. So I fucked that up, so I had to fix it later. But yeah, I just think it's so cool, like how using Flux kind of makes me use colors that I would never use, like that pink on his neck. Never I'll never use that because it's gross. I don't like cool tones. I hate cool tones. But I think it looks really good on his neck there. I also really like how his stubble comes out in the end. I think it looks pretty fucking awesome. See, you can see me fixing the fucking highlight, because for some, I read it as a hair strand. You know, that's the 2 a.m. brain. That's what happens. Yeah, I really like how traditional. This definitely has a more traditional look than the first painting. And that's pretty fun. I like being able to have that power. It feels like I'm playing God, but with art. Like, I get to decide, like, how I want it to look, you know? I don't know if I brought out his concealer as much here. I think I did. You can kind of see it a little bit. Yeah, this was definitely a painting. I wasn't sure if I was gonna go through with it, because it was pretty rough. But I was also just like, you know, fuck it, I'm not streaming, like, who gives a shit? So that's what made it easier too. But yeah, this one's just, it just has a mind of its own to me. And I would love to do more paintings like this. It just, for me, I feel like it takes a long time, because this one, I felt like it took forever, and I was completely patient with it. I took my time, and then I look, and it's like 3 a.m., and I'm like, damn, it's 3 a.m., and then I look at the video, and it took me 2 hours, I think. That was including the drawing, so that's pretty interesting. I think both paintings in total took about 4 hours and some change. And I've heard some people have told me that, oh, I worked fast, and I didn't think so until I realized I looked at other videos, and some people are like, this painting took me 4 hours. I'm like, oh. I mean, then again, the reason why it's probably faster is because look how sloppy it is. Like, I'm not gonna refine any of that. Like, I'm literally just cutting away and adding shapes, and I'm refusing to polish it and clean it. And that's usually why it probably seems like it's faster. I'm just doing less work, you know? But that's painting. That's painting. That's a style I always liked. Like, I don't really like, I personally don't like to paint so accurately. You know, like, where it's like you gotta smooth and blend. It's so much work, and to me it kind of kills the fun, because with this painting it's not completely accurate, no, but I think it really captures the essence of the mood of the, you know, the way he's looking. It's almost like kind of coy, kind of romantic, kind of shy, and I think I've captured that. That's important to me. That's what's important. Had I done the whole thing and it was all smooth and clean, but his eyes were like dead, I would be like, no, this is shit. Emotion and essence is very important to me when it comes to making art, and that's all I want to get, you know? That's what's important. I also think I got his mouth more accurately here too, so that's pretty fun. Oh man, I really like the way his nose area looks. Please tell me I didn't fix that shadow there, because if I did, I'm gonna be pissed. That looks so cool. But yeah, it's cool seeing, like, not noticing certain things. But yeah, I don't want to be like cocky or anything, but I do really like this painting. I think I popped off a little bit, as the kids say. Unfortunately, I also had the same problem with like the background. Had no idea what to do with it. You'll see that later though. I'll talk about that when we get to it. But yeah, stuff like paintings like this are just so relaxing. Like if I could get paid, I mean, I guess I can now since I'm an affiliate on Twitch, but if I could get paid just to sit, do a study every now and then and make my money, that'd be a dream. Because these are just great. I would never do an elaborate piece like this, like as commission, because it's too satisfying. I'm too selfish for that. It's too fun. But oh yeah, I did. Oh, never mind. Sorry, I was looking at something else. I don't know what I'm doing with the brush thing. But I was probably looking for a really good brush. Like when it comes to like certain parts of them, there's certain brushes I like to use. Like I feel like with digital painting, what helps make it look traditional is by changing your brushes a lot. Like don't you ever ever paint with one brush. I mean, unless you want to, you know, if you want to, that's fine. But if you're like, why does my painting look still digital? It doesn't look traditional. Use different brushes. It's gonna give it this liveliness. Oh, there he is dancing. It's gonna give it this liveliness that you don't get if you just use one, you know, one singular brush with no, like, even if you use one brush, at least change like the opacity or something. But yeah, if you want a traditional look, I definitely highly recommend changing your brushes constantly. It helps, and it's also fun. It's really fun doing that. Like, I like not being beholden to one brush. And there I go, fucking up the highlights. I'm so bad at highlights, man. And I know, I don't enjoy highlights, but it's because I don't get them. I don't understand highlights, and that's something I probably should study more. Because when I do pictures, I like to color dark hair or black hair, because I can just make it into a blob and get away with it. But with, like, I think I did an Alex Winter study. Well, I knew I did an Alex Winter study, but of him as Marco, and his hair was so beautiful, but I'm like, fuck, I don't know how to go about this. I'm not used to this challenge. So, it looked bad, I think. I think it looked pretty bad. Also, with that study, I did that thing where I kind of just give up, and I'm like, I kind of lost steam for it. Also because, even though it was a good picture, I don't think there was enough dimension in the portrait. Like, this Keanu portrait, there's not a lot of harsh shadows, but there's these rich highlights and these nice reds. Really, a lot of different colors going on in his face. And with the Alex Winter picture, he doesn't even have stubble, so there's no blues in there. It was really, it's kind of hard. But yeah, the more I look at this, the more I'm just like, man, it's pretty fucking cool. Like, I think I'm especially happy with his concealer on the right eye, which is your left. Like, the way that red brings it out. And again, I hope I didn't color over that, because if I did, I'm gonna be pissed. There's one thing I don't like doing, and that's overworking a piece. Like, I hate overworking a piece, so I try to just, I have to stop myself. Because I know every artist has this issue where you're just like, oh, you know, I'm having so much fun, I want to keep working on it. But it's like, you have to let them go, man. You got to say it's done, it's complete. And yeah, it's really cool. It's really cool also when you're painting something and like the, whatchamacallit? Like, whatchamacallit? There's a part of someone's face when you're painting. Like, you could have, like, your application could be great and all this, and you get the hair right, but then there's one part of their face where you're like, oh, something's off, and all you gotta do is just change, put a shape, put a square on their nose, or put this and that there, and it looks like them. I think that's insane to me. It's so fun. That's another reason why I like doing these studies, is because you figure out, like, what makes someone's nose look like that? what shape really is their eye? Like, what does it take to get the accuracy? And I think it's always really fun doing that, especially with Keanu, because he has such a great nose. Ugh, I love his nose. And I always get to, like, figure it out in the end, like, how his nose works. It's fun. But yeah, here's the fucking background. I really wanted to do a Gustav Klimt background, but then I'm like, there's already enough going on in his hair, and the way the paint is applicated, it's so, like, his face, there's so much going on, and then when you have that background, it's very loud, and I'm like, I don't want that. I also, I did my value check. Always check your values, because, you know, it really helps you understand, like, why something's off. Like, for here, I'm like, why does it feel like his face is competing with the background? So I put on the black and white filter thing on the picture, and it helped me see that, oh, the background, even though it has all these colors, because my eyes, I see so many bright colors, but the background is very dark, it's very faded, and that's what brings Keanu's face out. So I had to redo the background a few times. Yeah, that was pretty annoying. Because I'm really bad at abstract stuff, so. But yeah, I think I sort of got it. I don't know. At this point, I was like, well, he's done. That's what's important. Like, you know, why torture myself? But yeah, I really dig it. I think I do eventually go with the white background. Again, I do the thing where I have two versions. But you see in this painting how his face is competing with the background. I hate that. It's you know, you don't really look at him. And I want you to look at him. Because he's beautiful. Oh, I'm so happy I didn't fix the fucking the shadow. I would have punched myself if I did that. I was also trying to crop it too, but for some reason it looked like a meme. What meme? I don't know. It just looked meme-ish to me. But so yeah, since it's wrapping up, I would like to say what I really like about this painting. My favorite part is definitely his, just that shadow near his nose. It's awesome. It's just so good. Also, second thing, I like the highlight on his forehead. Really nice. It's really rich. What would I grade this painting? I think I would give it a... I'm gonna give myself A's. But I think I'll give this an A. A minus. I like it. I think it's great. It captures Kiki's beauty. It looks so dreamy. It's like... He looks like your crush, you know, that you see across the room. I think that's great. I think that's awesome. The white background's a little boring, but I really wanted his hair to come out, so yeah. So yeah, this painting is also finished. Just adding in a few little brush strokes to make it look more traditional. So it looks like I've literally painted on it. I also noticed I used the least amount of, like, layers for this, so... that's pretty fun. But yeah, those are my paintings. I hope you guys weren't too bored. So, yeah, I hope you enjoyed. If not, whatever. But if you did, cool. I'll see you later. Bye. I love you.